Hi everyone, it's Jen and Belle, and I'm here to do a small book haul with you today. I didn't go book shopping this week because, as you know, I got a ton of books last week from Borders, and there was nothing else that I could think of that I really wanted to get. And the only other books I would want to get are brand new ones, which they're not going to have at Borders. So I didn't get too much this week, but I did get a couple of books on my iPad or my Nook. Well, actually it's my Nook, but I have an iPad too. So I'm going to show you the pictures on there since the covers will be in color. And I did get one other book this week. I ordered it from Barnes & Noble, and it is 10 Things We Did and Probably Shouldn't Have. Belle, please don't lean on there. By Sarah Milanowski. And I've seen really great reviews on this. Excited to read it, actually. I think it's going to be a fun, laughing, fast read. Oh, Belle's leaving, and I know the computer's going to shake when she takes off, so. Okay, bye, Belle. All right, so yes, this is the one that I got, and I did look at the inside flap. It's pretty. It's black and shiny pink. Can you see that? I don't know if you can see it, shiny. Pretty. So, yeah, so got that one. And I'm on like a little mini vacation from work this week, so I'm hoping to read this one. I'm still reading the advanced reader's copy of Triangles that I got, that I won on Goodreads. So I'm not done with that one yet, but it's going really fast. So I'm sure I'll be able to get to this one. I really haven't read that much this week. I probably could have been done with Triangles a couple of days ago, but as you know, the 10th anniversary of 9/11 is coming up, and there's so much programming on right now about it, and I told you I'm addicted to it. I, like, not love it, but I don't know. It's something about it that really makes me interested. I want to know everything I can know about it, and there's a lot of different documentaries this year about it. A lot of the survivors have come on and done some programs, and also there's been one about pets, about how pets saved people that were survivors, and what else? There was one with George Bush and Rudy Giuliani and stuff that I've never seen before. So I've been spending a lot of time watching those at nighttime and not actually reading. So once it's all over and I've seen all my programming, I'll go back to my normal reading speed. But yeah, so I'm still on Triangles. Sorry, that was a long explanation. But I'm still on that one. And I think I'm either going to read this one next or Anna and the French Kiss. Because I want to try to get to these before, like, I know the summer's over, but it's still kind of summery, it's still kind of warm, so I think these are good, like, summer type kind of reading materials, so that's why I'm doing that. And I'm also reading Reclaiming Ter Shadain. Yes, I think that's how Craig told me to pronounce it. So I'm reading that one also for him. About like 50 pages in, really enjoying it. It's like magic and royalty and suspense. So I'm really enjoying that too, but I'm kind of reading that in between these other books so I can get them finished before the summer weather is over. And then I did buy, like I said, two books. It's going to take me a minute here. I did buy two books on the Nook this week because they were really good prices. They were by Jennifer Lawrence, and if you remember, she's the one who sent me my bookmarks last week in my mailbox, and this is one of her books, Season of Eden. And what struck me about this story was it was really something different. It's actually about, sorry about the glare of my lights, it's actually about a student falling in love with her teacher. Which is something that you don't see a lot of books about. I mean, I've seen a lot of books lately about somebody dying and having to go on, or a sick parent, and, you know, I have nothing, no bias against that. It's just that sometimes you just want to read something a little different, and this sounded like kind of like a taboo kind of thing, so, you know, I'm interested to read it. It sounded really good. Some reviews didn't like it, but I really think that's because of the subject matter and not because of the writing. So I can't give you my review yet. I haven't read it. And the other one I got was also by Jennifer Lawrence, Overprotected, and I mentioned this one also last week in my mailbox. And this one is about This rich girl and her dad hires this guy that she's hated all her life to be her bodyguard, and I think like dad doesn't want her to ever fall in love or have a boyfriend, and he just wants this bodyguard to protect her, and she and the bodyguard end up falling in love even though they've hated each other forever. So I thought that one sounded really good too, and the prices were really good on the Nook. They were $5 for each book, so that's a good price for me. Sometimes I can be cheap about things. So that's really it. That's my book haul in my mailbox for this week. I'm probably not going to have any time to film anything over the weekend, so hopefully these four videos I got today will keep you busy. And if you have any comments or anything you want to tell me about, please feel free to leave them. I love reading your comments, and I try to respond to them as fast as I can. What else? If you want to find me, I'm on Twitter. My name is Tinkerbell Pugs. And if you want to take a look at my blog for interviews that I've done with some authors for some books, my blog is readingwithpugs.blogspot.com. So if you're watching this and you haven't subscribed, feel free to subscribe. I love to talk to all my subscribers and watch your videos if you're doing any. And I want to thank you for joining, and I'll see you next week, and happy reading!